Hi everyone, I'm Reza. Today we'll go over how you can plot the pole figures using the simulation results of PRISM's plasticity. To start with, I assumed you have the plasticity package compiled. So we go to the folder Applications Crystal Plasticity FCC. Here we are going to simulate the FCC random orientation block. So CD FCC random orientation block. Here, in order to plot the pole figures, we need to have the quadrature output information. So we are going to change the parameters input file. So let's look at the parameters input file first. This simulation includes 5 by 8 by 10 discretization. So it will be 400 elements in total. And we want to output the visualization results. So let's set the right output equal to true. And then we want to have the outputs every 50 time steps. So in order to add quadrature outputs, we need to add two lines to the parameters file. So these two are set right quadrature output equal to true and set skip quadrature output steps to 50, similar to the other type of visualization result. Let's see what's the boundary condition. The total time is 5 and the time increment is 5 × 10⁻³. Sample is FCC and the microstructure is also 5 by 8 by 10. Let's go back to see what's the boundary condition. So VIM boundary conditions.txt. So here we are applying symmetric uniaxial boundary conditions. So it assumed that you're applying boundary condition uniaxially, but it uses the symmetry in the sample. So we are applying uniaxial compression along z direction. Considering the unit dimension of the sample, we will apply about 5% in compression. So the total number of increments will be 1000. So let's run the sample using MPI run N16 processors, the main executive address, and PRM. This simulation will take some time, but we'll be back after the simulation is finished. Okay, after 1000 increments, we have the simulation finished. So let's go and take a look at the folder results. This folder should now be very crowded. As you can see, we are using 16 processors for the simulation. So we have the numbers from 0 to 15 for each output, and at each 50 increments, we have an output. But the quadrature outputs are those which we are interested in. So you can see that each 50 increments we have one, but the one which we are interested in is the number 999, which is at 5% strain. So we want to plot the pole figure using the quadrature outputs 999 CSV. So the first step is to open the quadrature output 999 using Microsoft Excel. So first you need to get rid of all the columns except the updated orientations, which are in Rodriguez vector. It will be deleting all the columns except the columns 8 to 10, which are the updated Rodriguez vector for each integration point. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, delete this. And then 2, 3, and the rest. So after you deleted all the file, you need to save this. So if you open this file, you'll have just updated orientation for each integration point. Just to check the number of quadrature points, we have 400 elements. Each has 8 integration points, which in total becomes 3200 quadrature points. So we are good. So let's save this and close it. In order to plot the pole figure from the file that we just modified, we need to use the MATLAB package MTEX. So I assume you get the MTEX package ready in your MATLAB. So let's open MATLAB. First, we prepare the MATLAB script for you to plot the pole figures using the MTEX package. So you need to get that package, which is inside your PRISM's Plasticity GitHub package. You'll have it in your PRISM's package, but I just want to show you where you can find it. So if you open opened the Prism's Plasticity on GitHub, you can go on training materials and post-processing. There is this ori plot underlined big.m. This is the script we are going to use. So let's go back. Now let's open MATLAB. Okay, so first we need to open the script I just showed you. You can find that in the plasticity package that you git clone from the Prism's Plasticity GitHub. So let me open that. Now we have oriplot underline big.m opened. So after we open oriplot underline big.m, we need to make sure that our file quadrature output 999.csv is in the same folder as this script. So we need to modify some parts of this file to make it work for the FCC sample. First, this crystal symmetry is for HCP, so we need to change it for the FCC one. So we change CS to crystal symmetry cubic, and then the name of the file, we want to change it to quadrature output 999 CSV, so this will be changed. Next, if you open the quadrature output 999.csv with the text editor, for example Notepad++, you can see that it's comma delimited. So we need to change here the space delimited to comma delimited and then remove this. We don't need that anymore. And here the pole figures, these are for HCP system. So we change them to the 001, 011, and 111, which are for FCC crystal system. And that's it. The only thing we need to check before we run this script is if the code can correctly read the file or not. So let's put a breakpoint after the first appearance of that's here. So the file reads the input file, quadrature output 999, and it's 3,200 rows, which are the number of quadratures, and three columns, which are the updated orientations. Let's open the variables here, dats, and compare that versus the quadrature output file. So the first component is -3.29 × 10⁻³. So it's -3.21 × 10⁻³. So we are reading the correct file. So let's go back to the script and continue and see what's coming out of it. So these are the results, the pole figures, a 5% compression we got. So let's compare these results to the presented results in Prism's Plasticity paper. I minimized the results so we can put that next to the results of the paper and we can compare that. So let's bring up the results of the paper. So here you can see that definitely the results are getting closer, but be careful, this is for 40% compression, this is just 5%, and you don't have the color map similar as here. For example, here we are going all the way down to here, 0, but here we are basically saying that below 0.8 it's white, but if you make it the same as this, this region becomes blue. So we are getting there, and this one, it has the maximum here and there is a layer forming. That's it. Now you can plot your pole figures for your simulation using the same method. Just be careful, sometimes you need to change this file a little bit to fit your CSV file or mtext version, but that's something trivial. In this video, we went over how someone can plot pole figures out of the CPFE simulation using Prism's Plasticity. In the next video, we'll go over how someone can actually generate the macrostructure using an EBSD file and Dream3D software. Thanks for watching this video.